call you a little earlier. It's 8:05. I'm here in my traditional spot. There's sky down there. As you can see, these recent rains that we've been having have flooded the bayou. And the water level's a little higher than normal. Yeah, he's having fun down there. Anyway, we're not here to talk about sky, we're here to talk about my fight. Today I'm smoking out of the Forester Bent Billiard. This is, of course, has a condenser in it, and oh, guy, come on, he's in the bayou, he's swimming in the bayou, and that frightens me because the current is really strong right now. This guy's never swam before in his entire life. Anyway, the draw is pretty good. It's okay. I thought it was going to have a bad draw. Actually, it's pretty decent. And so far, this condenser does reduce the tongue bite a little bit. Man, he's having fun down there. I don't trust any of those waters. Because there's a bunch of snakes in there. Anyway, it's starting to heat up a little bit. Because it's not as thick as the imported briar pipe. The condenser is doing a pretty good job. It's absorbing the moisture. Doing it a lot better than the imported briar. Because it's a different shape. But anyway, the draw is a little snug on this pipe. And so far it's doing pretty well. I'll give you a full in-depth review when I'm done with this. Not when I get home. But see, what am I gonna speak about? Before I get into my contest, let's talk a little bit about I carry. When I'm out here I carry a pouch. Inside this pouch I have my tobacco. This sleeve here is for my pipe. My tamper, my matches, and a pipe cleaner. I'm gonna get something a little more streamlined than this though. Because that's a little bulky. Hold on a second. Guy, come here. Come on. Come here. Come on, guy. It started. Yeah, it started gurgling. I was waiting for it to do that. That's the problem with condensers. It builds up and you get gurgled like you've never heard before. And I don't know what to do with it. I can't put filters on it. I can't do any of that other stuff to it. I think I'm just going to end up taking the condensers out of it. I figured out how to take it off that imported briar pipe, which I was worried that I wasn't going to be able to do that. But anyway, pipe pouch. It's a question I have for the rest of you guys when you take your pipes on the go, what do you take your pipe in? You just take the pipe alone in your pocket, or do you have a bag or a case that you carry it in? I have everything here. It's something I just started doing. Anyway, I said congratulations to myself. I've gone over my expectations, and I was originally wanting 30 subs, now I have 35 subs. So now we're ready to do my contest. So stay tuned for this Friday, Freehand Friday, which is why I want to do it on that day. Freehand Friday. And I will discuss... Ah, crap. Sky, if you get taken away by the current, I'm not going to jump in after you. That's it. Stay here, because you reek now. No. The lighter out, so. Do it, because see? Bridge out the distance. Sun is setting in the distance. The bayou's over flooded. And sky is soaking wet. Until next time, guys, I'll finish this up. Give you the full review when I get home. And I'll see you then.
Alright, I'm home. And it's time for the review of this pipe. This is the Forester. Made in England. Why is it not focusing? In London, England. Let's see now. Yeah, London, England. And let's talk about first. I want to mention its length, because out of all of the pipes that I have, well, all the pipes in this style that I just meant in normal bent, I've just bent pipes, this is the longest one that I have, longest bent billiard I have. The stem is a lot longer. It's the longest bent billiard I have, and it's actually fairly comfortable when you hold it in your mouth. It's got a good balance to it, and I wanted to talk about the condenser mechanism on this one, which you see here, is slightly better than the one that was on the imported Briar pipe. It still has gurgling. It still has the gurgling problems and all that, but this one didn't do it as bad as the other one did. And it's just because it holds much more of the moisture than the other one did. The point of the condenser is that it's kind of like a permanent filter. What happens is that when you smoke the pipe, the moisture and everything builds up in this part. When you start to hear it gurgle, you take it out, wipe it clean, and then you put it back in the pipe. And this one was actually held, was a lot easier to use. It held the moisture more, so you can take it out and wipe it, put it back in, and your gurgle was gone. in the other pipe, no, it didn't really, it would just drip down to the bottom of the pipe. It didn't really hold a lot of the condensation. This pipe, so it's good, it's comfortable, it's got a pretty deep bowl, nice good pack. The crack and split that was here in the front has been repaired and that held. And it held very nicely. It's very nice briar. The draw on this pipe is very restrained. And that is because of the bend on the stem. Because it is actually very difficult to get a pipe cleaner through this pipe. I mean through this stem. You have to have a very straight pipe cleaner. You have to be very, very slow. Otherwise, it will not go through. It'll just crush on you. Getting a pipe cleaner through this stem is very difficult. But anyway, overall, it's a pretty good pipe. Although I don't like the, although it's pretty common looking. I mean, this is why I gravitate more to the imported briar, the bent apple, rather than this one. But this is a very good smoking pipe nonetheless. It's good weight, good balance. Kind of okay draw. It does give you a lot of smoke though. And this is a very nice pipe. So I still don't know if I'm going to hold on to this one or if I'm going to sell it or get rid of it or give it away or something, but for now, I'm going to hold on to it. It's pretty good. It's good. I'll keep playing with it a little bit more and see how I fare it out. And if I choose to get, and if later on I can choose down the line, if I need ever need to get rid of his pipes, I think this might be the first one to go. Who knows? So far, it's okay. It functions pretty well. And it gives you a pretty nice smoke. The smoke is pretty cool because it's a little bit longer. And I wish I had better tobacco to do it better justice. But no, I still have to deal with that crap that I bought at the... that I bought a few days ago. Yeah, I'm the sooner I'm done with that, the better. Alright, well, that's the review of the English Forester Bent Billiard. And stay tuned for the next one, which should be the Palace Royale pipe. And after that, that would be the end of this series for the Yabo estate pipes, the Yabo in English estate pipes. And then after that, I guess I'll have to go on with the Medico, which I already smoked it yesterday, and I have many things to say about that pipe. So. But it wouldn't be fair. I have to give you a first-hand experience, so I will smoke that again, and I will give you that experience as I'm smoking it. All right. Thanks.